It's nice to have someone on set who's actually taller than Chris Sims. Sims is 6'5". Our next guest, 6'6", quarterback of Oregon, now heading to the National Football League. He's Justin Herbert here with us live. Justin, what's up, buddy?
Appreciate you guys. Thanks for having me.
Hey, great to spend some time with you. We know it's a busy time for you here in Indianapolis. You will be throwing. You will be doing the full workout, or
Correct.
Any limitations at
just,
all?
Just no benching. I'll stick away from benching.
No benching?
Yeah.
Yeah, you could probably do some benching numbers, though. I think you probably, negative Ghost Rider, he can't. What led you to wanting to work out? What is it about you, your camp, where you said, you know, we're going to work out, not going to wait for the pro day?
Yeah, I just want to be a competitor. I just want to go out and throw the ball around, and I want to give teams a good look at myself and just be honest with them and go out there and have some fun.
Right.
What is your ceiling, do you believe, when it's time for the names to get called?
I don't know. Where everything happens, it'll happen, and I just have to deal with it. And I'm excited to be here. It's an honor to be invited to this experience, and I'm really looking forward to it.
What are you most nervous about?
Not nervous about anything. I'm excited. This is such a great opportunity that not too many people get to go through. And being here, it's an honor. And to be around such great talent, it's been a lot of fun already.
You're super talented. I mean, big time talent. Mike's
Thank
heard
you.
Me say this before. Like, I think you could be the most talented guy in the draft. What is the one thing you hear from teams after the Senior Bowl, or the thing that you feel like you need to show some of these other NFL teams, like, I can improve in this area, or something that you want to work on?
Yeah, a lot of it's footwork. Never taken a snap from under center before.
Right.
Prior to these 2 months of training, a lot of it's leadership. I've never been outside of Eugene, Oregon, and
right.
That's kind of where I've stayed for my whole life.
Right.
So it's just all about how I'd mesh with a new locker room, a new culture, and things like that.
What do you say to those people who question that? Because that's the first thing I heard about you with like people around the NFL. The concern was, oh, he's never been out of Eugene. You know, what kind of kid is he? Is he going to be good in a big city? Whatever. So, like, what's your answer to that?
Yeah, that's a great point. I've really enjoyed my time in Eugene, Oregon.
Yeah.
I've loved that place, and these past 2 months that I've spent away from it, I've really enjoyed it. On my own, playing football, and I don't think there's anything better than that. And I've really enjoyed these past 2 months.
All right, cool.
You were the MVP of the Senior Bowl. What did you learn most from that whole week, that whole process, that you think is going to help prepare you for what's coming in the NFL?
Yeah, it's kind of about how an NFL team works. I got to learn a playbook, got to be around guys and had to call plays in the huddle, and had to go under center. And so a lot of things that I didn't do in college, I had to do there, and got to kind of see just how it works. And I thought it was a great week and really enjoyed it.
You're coming to the NFL. I want to know two things. Who was your idol growing up, and who's the guy that you'd be most excited to see this year on the field where you're just like, oh, my gosh, I can't believe I'm playing against this person. Any jump out names?
I would say Joey Harrington. I grew up watching him, and so he was
He's going to Oregon. He's going Oregon idol.
And
then
I would say to play against someone, Tom Brady.
Tom Brady. Yeah. That would be the one. Okay. I was expecting someone different than Joey Harrington. I'm not going to lie.
Not a whole lot of Joey Harrington fans out there. You may instantly be the president of the
Oregon
fan club.
Yeah. You totally caught me by surprise with that one. But I get it. I mean, he's an Oregon guy, and he was pretty big time there at Oregon.
Yeah, he was.
Wasn't he on the cover of one of the college football games way back in the day? Are you a Madden guy or a Fortnite guy? Or both?
Madden.
Madden?
Good.
Yeah.
My man.
What,
PS4 or Xbox?
Xbox.
Ah, if you were PS4, I'd let you beat me by 100 points.
Well, he would. Don't worry. He definitely would. All right. A lot of talk about, first off, your hand size.
Mm-hmm.
What'd you get measured in at yesterday?
10 inches.
10 inches. Okay, cool. All right, so wait. This is a great experiment. Because my hand, I already know his hands, mine are bigger wide-wise, but see how his are longer?
His fingers are longer.
So that's what I'm saying. They need to change the measurement process.
It should be bottom of the hand all the way to the top of the middle finger.
I have a double-jointed thumb. It's not fair. Like,
what did you measure in it?
I got in 10 and a half.
Wow.
Yeah, because I could really spread them out that way because both are double-jointed. I could do this too. So that's not fair, right? Okay, now grip the football. I'd like to see your grip just because we're talking about it a lot. So he's a 2 and under 5 guy. Another guy that's like that. Joe Burrow's kind of like that. Aaron Rodgers is like that. You always gripped it like that?
That's just kind of the way it...
It's just the way it does it.
I grabbed the ball and I threw it.
Yeah, you don't even think about it. You've always done it. And you haven't had to play with it like as compared to a college football to an NFL ball. You're still gripping it the same way, right?
Same way.
Yeah, okay, so there you go.
Did you notice a difference when you got an NFL ball in your hands versus the college football you were used to?
Not too much. I mean, there's a little bit of a change, but... Overall, you get used to it, and a couple weeks into it, you're
you like it better or worse?
I do enjoy throwing the NFL.
Right?
Ball.
The laces are better. The leather's better quality, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I know. Go ahead.
When did you realize, Justin, when was that moment, whether it was a pass, whether it was a decision, a moment, anything, that you can get it in the NFL, that you can get it done, that you're destined to play in the NFL and succeed there?
I don't know. I think that's just something that you kind of get a feel for. And I don't think there was one specific moment. I think over the course of my career, I feel like I've had enough success, and I feel like I am confident with my abilities that playing at the next level is something I want to do. I want to play this game as long as I can, and when I'm done playing, I want to coach. I want to be around this game for as long as I can, and whether it's long enough or not, I'm going to be ready when it comes, and just excited to be here.
There was a lot of talk last year that you would have been a top 20 pick. What ultimately led you to staying in college one more year?
A whole lot of reasons. I wanted to finish the year off with the guys that I came in with. Right. We had a great group of seniors this year. Wanted to come back, wanted to be better. I felt like I could improve. My younger brother was going to be on the team. Growing up in Oregon, always was a Duck fan, so there was nothing better than that.
It was special to you. Yeah.
What position did your younger brother play?
Tight end.
Now, numbers wise, I mean, I don't want to, like, you don't have to predict, but you're going to do everything. You're going to run the 40, mm-hmm. do it all. Like, come on, give me a ballpark. Like, ballpark, what do you think 40 you can do? We're not going to, like, you know, if you don't meet it, we won't get on you too hard.
As long as it's below a 4.8, I'm good with
you're
that.
You're going to be happy.
Yeah.
I mean, you think you got a chance to do like 4.68, 4.69?
Hopefully.
He's too shy and nice. Of course you do. Of course you do.
You don't want to set the bar too high, though. Okay. You want to set it low,
well,
and then it's
I've been
success.
Watching him run down the sideline
just
for 40-yard touchdown.
A sub-6. As long as they get under 6, I'll
well,
be happy.
Well, he said under 4.8, but he's going to run under 4.8.
That's good.
That was a very broad answer.
That's good.
Under 6 seconds, if yeah.
Yeah, there we go. That's good. Then it's going to be a smashing success. He busted it by more than a second and a half. What sport would you be playing if you weren't playing football?
Not basketball, that's for sure.
No, you're 6'6".
I'd probably be playing baseball.
What position did you play?
I played pitcher.
You're a pitcher?
I played shortstop for most of my life, and then I hit a growth spurt, so they had to move me out of shortstop.
Oh, yeah, you're too big to
too
play that
position.
Too many
balls going through my leg, yeah.
That's great. So then they pitcher, and what, did you go to the outfield at all?
First base.
Just first base. Yep. You did that. Now, you know, right now, oh, we got to go. Okay,
we
got to
let him go.
Yeah,
he's got a lot more to do, but we got Justin Herbert. Buddy, hey, congratulations, and good luck moving forward. Have a great time here in Indianapolis.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.